Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the look of a miniature toy from a photo, as well as create customized depth of field using the tilt shift filter first introduced in CS6. Open a photo of a scene that you'd like to make into a miniature. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. The most effective results are often with photos taken from above, looking downward with an angle on the subject. The entire photo should be in focus. Go to Filter, Blur Gallery, and Tilt Shift. If you're using CS6, the Tilt Shift filter is under Filter and Blur. If you don't see the Tilt Shift's on-screen controls, press Ctrl or Command H. You can position the controls over the area of your image that you want to remain in focus by going to the center point of the widget and dragging it. The other controls will follow. In this example, I want this section of my image to be in focus. The outer ring of the widget controls the blur amount. By rotating it clockwise or counterclockwise, it will increase or decrease the blur. You can also adjust the blur amount by dragging the blur slider to the right or left. If we drag the solid lines away from the center point, there will be more of your image in focus. The areas between the solid lines and the dashed lines are the transition areas. The blur grows progressively from the solid lines toward the dashed ones where it reaches full strength. The areas outside the dashed lines are 100% blurred. You can also rotate the entire tilt shift effect by hovering your cursor over or under the dot, and when the shape changes into a curved double arrow, rotate the blur. You'll often see an image distortion along its edges in macro photography. To simulate that effect, there's a distortion feature that you can apply. Dragging the slider to the right will add a zoom effect to the blur, but by default, this distortion is applied only to the bottom part of the image. To apply it to both parts, check the symmetric distortion option. Dragging the distortion to the left adds a spin effect. I'll set it at 53%, but feel free to play with the amount. To see your image better, press Ctrl or Command H to hide the controls. Once you're happy with your miniature effect, click OK at the top. Since most toys are very colorful, let's increase the vibrancy of your photo's colors. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Vibrance. Drag the Vibrance slider all the way to the right. In this example, I'll show you how to create a customized depth of field, including how to add a bokeh light effect. Open a photo that you'd like to add a gradual depth of field and that has some points of light. Open the tilt shift filter and drag it to the part of your image that you want to remain in focus and adjust the blur amount. I'll drag the solid line below my image to ensure that everything between it and the top solid line will remain in focus. I'll drag my image down to reposition the focused area and drag the transition until I like the result. I'll check symmetric distortion and slide the distortion to the right. Lastly, I'll add a bokeh effect, which reproduces the effect of light flaring in the lens. I'll drag the light bokeh slider to the right and left to adjust its intensity. You can also increase the intensity of the color surrounding the bokeh. You can control how much of the bright area burns out by dragging the light range sliders. If you drag the dark slider to the left, a greater range of highlights is now burned out. Have fun experimenting with the blurs and bokeh effect to get just the right combination for your photo. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.